Dear students, welcome to the video tutorial on Koha ILS. This video tutorial is entitled as Introduction to Koha ILS, and here we are going to study different aspects of Koha ILS. As you already know, what is an open source software and what are the role of open standards in shaping the future of library automation. And Koha is playing a major role in shaping the future of library automation, as it is almost become a de facto global standards and installed all over the world. User base already increased up to 3500 installation, and importantly, some of the national libraries are also using Koha for their library automation purposes. Before entering into details of Koha, let us have some historical features that we call historical foundation of Koha. Koha interestingly started to reduce the Y2K bug. There is a public library trust in New Zealand that is called Harawana Library Trust, popularly known as HLT. Now HLT requires to have a new ILS because of a Y2K bug of the existing program. So they actually prepared an RFP, and one particular vendor, that is the Katipo, they actually entered into the domain and developed the software for them. And January 5, 2000, Koha went live. They named as this particular software as Koha. Koha is a term taken from the Maori language. Maori is an oldest tribe in New Zealand. So in Maori language, Koha means an unconditional gift. So they have given the name of that particular software as Koha. It went live in HLT in January 5, 2000, and fortunately HLT decided to release or open up the software under GNU public license in July 2000. So right from July 2000, Koha became available in the public domain. Lot of people downloaded and experimented different features of Koha. So that is a bit history of Koha. Now by 2002, already it released in July 2000, by 2002 things really got moving with the new developers, because a lot of new developers attracted to Koha community, and a large library in US, Nelsonville Public Library in Ohio, they implemented Koha as their automation software. Then onwards different version of Koha came. Koha right from version 1 started in 2000, then version 3 came in 2008 with lot of new features. Say for example, incorporation of Jabra search engine, tagging in the OPAC, that means OPAC become interactive, improvements of level creator, notice generation, guided report, lot of customized report and predefined reports can be generated in Koha, complete Mach 21 support. So all incorporated in Koha 3.0 in 2008. And thereafter, Koha become very popular all over the world. You can have a visit to koha-community.org to know the user base presently available with the Koha. And you can see through Google Maps, mostly all over the world is Koha is in use for different libraries. In India also, the use of Koha software is increasing. Kerala government already declared Koha as their official software. In West Bengal, around 2500 public libraries are using Koha. And many university libraries, many IITs, NITs are using Koha nowadays. And almost in India also, Koha is becoming a de facto standard for library automation. Now, Koha in 2016, versioning system is changing from major.minor to build to yy.mm.xx format. Say for example, release is due in May 2006, and that release will be known as 16.05.00. Here 16 indicates the year 2016, 5 indicates the month, 05 indicates the month, that is the May, and build number is .00. So versioning system is changing from major.minor to build to from yy.mm to xx format. So it's a very brief history of Koha. The details of the history is available with each software. If you install Koha and open up the about Koha part, there will be a tab to indicate the release cycle and development of Koha in timeline format. Okay, so you can consult that. Now, as we already understand from the previous tutorials, that FLOSS or open source software gives us freedom to operate at the system level. Now we can call them as system librarians. It helps building community computing, allows extensive customization through GPL. I am going to show you some of the customization of Koha, provides powers to modify and distribute, and based on LAMP architecture, and provides freedom to libraries to operate, to modify, to customize, to distribute, to redistribute the software for different library activities. Now, FLOSS in library automation, as we already know, offers substantial cost saving for library of automation. Support is not locked to a single vendor. That means you can hire a programmer for customization purposes. Generates international collaboration and international librarianship. These open source software are also based on open source companion software. For example, Koha is based on three companion software apart from Linux: Apache as web server, MySQL as backend RDBMS, and Perl as a programming environment. But it uses many other, you know, simultaneous scripting language like Java, JavaScript, etc. But Perl is the major programming environment for Koha. And Koha can be customized to meet different individual requirements of a library. And at the same time, you see that Koha offers a new opportunity to experiment different innovative features we want to introduce in library services. So, as a quick sum up, we can say that open source library automation like Koha provides us three fundamental benefits. One is the fund. We do not have to pay anything to anybody to procure the software. Then freedom, we can customize the software to any extent, and fraternity, because we are operating at the international brotherhood. That means somebody is using Koha in India and somebody using Koha in Brazil, they can interact with different kind of communication channel. The open source software is providing lot of communication channels: IRC relay chat, discussion forum, mailing list, and many other things. So, in most of the cases, if you find any problem with the Koha, you just report that problem in discussion forum, and within 24 hours you will be getting response from other people who are using Koha. So here librarians are helping librarians to build a perfect international Koha community. Now, different ILSS are available in the library domain. We already studied Avantika, Emilda, GNUtica, Koha, Librarian, NewGenLib. But we already know that Koha, NewGenLib and Emilda are in the matured block, and they are fairly matured, and possibly Koha is the first and the most comprehensive product of this series of open source ILSS. Now, here if we go for a comparative study with the available closed source commercial product in Indian library community and Koha, we arranged all the software alphabetically. We have taken Alice for Windows, Basis Plus and Technip Plus, Koha, Libsys, Soul, Slim 21, NGTLMS and VirtuALS. Here you see we compared this software against a 10 point parameters, and the highest score obtained VirtuALS, but Virtua is hugely costly commercial ILS available from US, and Koha score 9 out of 10 in this evaluation framework. So Koha is comparable with each and every commercial software available in the domain of library automation presently available in India, and many Indian libraries are also using, as you know. Now, in this particular section of the tutorial, we will study different features of Koha. So, this is basically the logo of Koha generated by the community to use in the software. And the remarkable features of Koha is that it is the first open source library management software. It is Unicode compliant right from the beginning, supports Mark 21 family of standards, not only that means not only bibliographic format, it also supports authority format, holding format and classification format, but community information format support is presently not readily available, but anyone can create a framework for community information resources by using the cataloging editor of Koha. And interestingly, Koha supports Z39.50 in two-way basis. That means it includes a client through which you can download different validated MARC records from different Z39.50 server available globally. And at the same time, you can use your Koha to serve other libraries your validated MARC record for downloading. So Koha can act as a Z39.50 client and Z39.50 server at the same time. It's a unique feature of Koha. Apart from Koha, only Virtua is doing that thing in Indian library system. Right from the beginning, it is web enabled, available free of cost, and provides freedoms of customization, includes all the features of a typical fourth generation library management system, and ensures all the core activities of library automation we need in Indian system. This is the earlier logo of Koha. Now let us go to study features of Koha under different heads. Now first point, we would like to cover the technical features of Koha. Up to version 2.x, Koha was available both for Unix like operating system and Windows platform. But right from the version 3.0, Koha is available only for Unix like operating system. There is no Windows version presently available with the Koha. That is right from the version 3.x release from 2008. Koha is fully web centric in architecture. That means you do not need to install different or separate web suite to offer your OPAC over the web, that means web OPAC, which we normally do with the Sol. Sol do not come with the ready web OPAC support, we need to install a separate module for that. But Koha is web centric in architecture, that means all kind of library related activities through the staff interface you can do over the web. Similarly, user can search OPAC through web, and different kind of interactive features are also available. Right from the beginning, it supports Unicode for processing multi-script bibliographic records, and almost all kind of index script we have tested, it is working fine with Koha. Now other technical features are, suppose I already told you, it is based on LAMP architecture, it uses MySQL as backend RDBMS, powerless programming environment, Apache as web server, and interestingly all these dependent softwares are also available as open source. Two separate interfaces it support, one for the librarian interface, we normally call it staff interface, and another for end user, we normally call it Koha OPAC. Inbuilt web OPAC support, supports almost all bibliographic standards available globally, that is ISO 2709, MARC, XML, ADFACT, Z39.50, and present versions of Koha are also compatible with NCIP, NISO Circulation Interchange Protocol. So this is a tremendous, you know, mileage for Koha in compare with the other Indian library automation system available commercially. Those are not compatible with this huge set of globally agreed upon standards like ADFACT, Z39.50 server, then NCIP, etc. Koha supports all globally agreed upon data standards related to library automation. That is a unique feature of Koha. Now if we go to study the different other general features of Koha, it is free to download, you do not have to pay any license fees to anybody, fully customizable, establishing an international community of users, and thereby help is just an email away, generating an international spirit of cooperation and collaboration, that is much required for Indian libraries, because we need to know what our counterparts are doing in different developing countries. Easy staff training, lot of tutorials are available. Koha has got a 700 page manuals, and that manual is so comprehensive in nature, you don't have to read any other materials apart from that manual. So that is again a good feature available with the Koha, comprehensive support, documentation, etc. It's supported by a lot of communication channel. I already told you IRC, Internet Relay Chat, Discussion Forum, Mailing List. It supports comprehensive privilege control in granular level. That means you can allocate different responsibilities to different staffs And even that, those responsibilities can be granular in nature. And very interestingly, it supports branch library management. That means if you are running a different libraries in different sites, say for example, a university like IGNU, they have n number of centers. And right from the central location at Delhi, they can manage all the branch library with different circulation rules, with different library stack, with different item types, etc. So right from the beginning, Koha supports independent branch management. That's again a unique feature not available in other Indian library automation software like Sol and Libsys. Now at the bibliographic standard level, I already told you Koha is completely compatible with Mark 21 family of standards and UniMark bibliographic format. Most of the French speaking countries are using UniMark as a global bibliographic format inside Koha. That means say for example a library in France, rather than using Mark 21 bibliographic format, they may prefer UniMark inside the Koha. Two bibliographic format supports are inbuilt in Koha. Interestingly, it supports Mark 21 authority format, and the authority records generated by Koha can be automatically linked to bibliographic records. It's again a unique feature not available with other software. It supports pickup list for control number and code fields of Mark 21 bibliographic format. Say for example, your library is handling more than one language material. So each language has got a separate Mark 21 code, or Mark code rather. So all that code, by using all that code, you can prepare a pickup list and you can link that pickup list with the language tag, that is 041 subfield A in Koha Mark 21 editor. As I already told you, it includes both Z39.50 client for distributed cataloging, because it's a great opportunity. You can reduce the cost, unit cost of cataloging by using Z39.50 client. You can save time and energy by copying validated MARC record through Z39.50 client available in Koha. And it includes inbuilt thesaurus support. That's again an interesting thing in Koha, because all the access points like 1xx field, 7xx field and 6xx fields can be linked with internal thesaurus available in Koha with the required structure. So that's a great facility for cataloger to go for the standardized mode of cataloging. Other bibliographic facilities available are that you can use different bibliographic framework for different library materials. As you know, Mark 21 is a huge set of tags and subfields. So from that tags and subfields pool, you can create one framework for books, one framework for thesis, one framework for serials, and so on. So it always helpful for library professional to pick up the framework first. That is, that means we are going to catalog a book now. So we are picking up the biblio framework related to monograph, and there all the fields related to monograph will be coming only. Easy editing of Mark 21 tags and subfields. At any moment of time, you can on a tag, you can off a tag. It supports linking of authority file in real time. Easy linking with the standard codes and other leads, and you can always export and import records on the basis of ISO 2709 and MARC XML. You can validate MARC records through MARC testing and MARC checking in Koha. It provides easy support for member card generation, stock verification, stock taking, etc. Now, in case of acquisition module, we can go for the multiple book budget. We can create suppliers database support, real-time budget information. Every time you can check the availability of the fund, vendor-specific orders, fund utilization information, real-time accounting, and email-based communication with the vendors. And as I told you that Koha presently includes the support for EDIFACT. So right from the version 16.05, which released on 27th May 2016, so there you can place use Koha to place order directly to the vendors through a payment gateway. You can send SMS to your users as a reminder for the overdue books, and many other things you can now do with the these protocols. Now, if we go to the cataloging module of Koha, update is very fast and slick, support for both Mark 21 Unimark, supports FRBR but partially, supports IAJ toolkit to index records, because Koha at the back end it is using Jabra search engine. So, IAJ toolkit is a middleware rather, which is linking basically the Jabra indexing engine and Koha software. And as I told you, you can search both bibliographic record and authority record through this Jabra search engine. At the circulation, we have Koha provides almost all basic operations, that is issue, returns, renewals, user driven reservation, barcode scanner, that is barcoded circulation is possible. Present Koha versions are completely amenable to RFID also. It can generate a list of overdues for phone reminder system, borrowed photo display system in circulation panel, overdue notice generation in one click, various report related to circulation, and easy membership management is another feature of Koha. Right from the beginning, Koha OPAC is web enabled. User can log on by using their required login and password. They can create virtual bookshelf, they can go for user driven reservation, they can have reading history they can save in their user page, they can check what are the fines and due amounts presently available with the system. And nowadays Koha OPAC is also available on the mobile, because recently Koha changed the OPAC theme into Bootstrap theme, and it is quite mobile friendly, so your user can access Koha through their smartphone also. Other information if we consider, it can generate spine level, barcode, membership card, issue slip during circulation, comprehensive report generation, it can be linked with the PI week to create real time usage statistics, printing and display of reports in different formats. You can directly take the reports in CSV format and convert into Excel format or OpenOffice format. So, those are the facilities available presently. Koha 3, the journey of Koha 3 started in 2009, and till date we have the version, I already told you versioning system has changed. Presently in the May 2016, we have version 16.05.00, and it supports all the features of Koha 2.x and all the additional features I already told you, that is the overall features of Koha. And presently it is opting for the standards like SRU, SRW, then OpenSearch. You can now the latest version of Koha supports OpenID also. That means if you have an ID with the Google, you can log on. It is supporting Mozilla persona login also. That means you have a user ID with the Mozilla, by using the same user ID you can log on into Koha. So these are the present things are working on. Koha OPAC can be easily integrated with the citation tools like Zotero, Mendeley, and supports for 3M. That means Koha is readily amenable with the RFID project. Different RFID vendors can readily link their product with the Koha. Right from the beginning, it is web compliant, but recent versions of Koha are web 2.0 compliant, because they can generate RSS feed again each query. Information mashup is supported in Koha OPAC. That means n number of sources can be connected together in Koha OPAC on the fly. User can submit their comments, ratings, tags, etc. That means Koha OPAC is interactive, collaborative and participative. As I told you that previously Koha follows this particular formula, major, minor, revision, build, but now they are following for versioning year, month, build formula, and the numbering system is becoming slightly easier to understand. 16.05 means the release, May release in 2016. This is the about Koha tab. When you are installing Koha, it gives you real time server information, it gives you all the Perl module installed by the system, and this is the required Perl module. Altogether there are 68 Perl modules you need to run Koha. As I told you, Koha is based on Perl programming language environment. The journey of Koha from 2.x to 3.x, these are the technological differences. We started with the CGI, shifted to Ajax, Web 1.0 to Web 2.0, limited report to comprehensive report, no mashup to full mashup. Then Koha can also use as content management system. No support for sophisticated search. Now presently Koha support all kind of sophisticated search including fuzzy searching. So these are the comparative study between the Koha 2.x release and 3.x release. If you go for installation, it includes 4 different steps. First you need to go for installation of any GNU Linux. Normally people are using Debian and Ubuntu. Install MySQL 5.0 onwards, the present version of Koha supports 5.7 of MySQL. You need to install Apache, you need to install Perl. Perl is almost readily available with all kind of Linux release. Then you can install PHP MyAdmin as a MySQL front end tool to manage your MySQL database. You need to install Perl modules related to Yaj and Zebra, and all other Perl modules related to CPAN. Now, when your system is ready, then you can go for installation of Koha through web installer. So, as a whole, the whole installation process can be customized into 3 groups. That is the installation of LAMP architecture, installation of Perl module, and installation of Koha through web installer. This is the main interface or stop interface of Koha. You see all the modules are available here. And you can access this interface over the web from anywhere. And this is the OPAC interface of Koha. As I told you, Koha can have inbuilt Thesaurus support. Here you see a Koha customized Koha OPAC where the inbuilt Tema Trace support is actually triggered with the Koha OPAC. Thank you very much for attending the tutorial.